In the 12 months that it's taken the Manic Street Preachers to become the band everybody loves to hate, they've spent 4 months in the studio recording their debut album, Generation Terrorists, for their new record company, and so far the band have cost them almost £1 million. Indie credibility is not something that matters to the Manics.
We always said we wanted to be on a major, seeing where you can never reach people. You know, we were never interested in being a really critically respected independent band, because they're the bands that always let us down in the 80s, the bands that never said anything, that never looked any good. The thing that made us really bitter.
Being on a major just makes everything much easier. You know, you can use all their money, use all their resources, use all their marketing, tell them what to do, and they do it like obedient serfs.
Accusations of hype have dogged the Manic Street Preachers every step. Self-mutilation, trashing their guitars on stage, declaring their hate for every band in existence, and their ambition to be the best band in the world have not helped matters.
People can't, they think it's hype and everything, but people do really like our songs. And everything we do, we've got complete confidence in. We wouldn't say things like we would want to be the biggest band in the world and sell 60 million albums if we didn't know we had good songs.
And we always preferred like Slash and Axl to Harold, but...
Manics are not the glam punk pretenders some people think they are. They spent their childhoods trying to escape from the South Wales mining town where they lived, reading the music press and situationist text, watching Marilyn Monroe films, listening to Public Enemy, Queen.
Mick Jagger doing Jumpin' Jack Flash, Pete Townshend smashing his guitar, Sex Pistols, not the Clash anymore, Axl, Slash.
Harry rocks.
Just divorcing yourself from your surroundings just by the way you look.
Watching
that's
William,
glamour.
Watching William Burroughs, Ken Kesey, most Jack Kerouac, Camus. Old books were just as exciting to us as records. You know, there wasn't much difference.
Generation Terrorists is a double album released next week. It includes a remix of one track by Public Enemy producers The Bomb Squad and a track called Little Baby Nothing, which features the vocals of ex-porn star Tracy Lords.
It just seemed like more symbolic than anything else, the way, you know, just men are the most horrible people in the world, and you as women, we just want to show a woman who had power
and intelligence
and who was articulate. People, you know, just because of a porn background, obviously think dirty slut, really unintelligent. And we just obviously knew it wouldn't be like that. And when we met her, she was one of the, probably the most intelligent American we've ever met in our lives. You know, and she was just perfect for the song.
You Love Us was originally released when they were on independent label Heavenly, but with songs like Stay Beautiful, Methadone Pretty and Crucifix Kiss on the new album, the Manics' idea of romance has nothing to do with Barbara Cartland novels.
Romantic realists. You know, we're always aware we're never blinded by too much flowery aesthetics. Our romance is always based on where we come from anyway. And a desire to escape boredom.
Our romance is having just like total power, and that we've just got nothing to lose, you know, because we're secure in the knowledge that we already lost a long time ago.